The class is in memory of Jared Orchin. The name of the parsha is Ki Tavo. The first mitzvah of this parsha is about Bikurim. What is Bikurim? Bikurim is when a farmer in Israel goes into his farm, into his field, vineyard, and he sees the first fruit, he has to make a sign on it, and basically the mitzvah is to bring your first fruit to God. You bring it in a basket, you go to Jerusalem, to the temple, and you come there and you say a monologue that is basically a way to say thank God. Start to say with, I remember how you say thank you. You mention, you start from the beginning, the Jews were, Jacob was by Laban the Aramean, and he wanted to eradicate them. He wanted to destroy them. What means he wanted to destroy them? He wanted to assimilate them. Laban wanted to assimilate Jacob and his family. That's why he tried to delay his going back to Israel. He tried to raise his grandchildren his way, not the Jewish way. And then we mentioned that we were in Egypt, and we were there suffering for 210 years, and God took us out from Egypt, and finally brought us to the land of Israel. And look now, I'm bringing the first fruit from my farm, and I'm thanking you, God. That's the mitzvah of Bikurim. They bring the first and the best to God. But the Torah says something very interesting. When you come to the land and you conquer it, then you should bring Bikurim. The Talmud says, when is the time? Only after the whole nation was settled, the farmer was obligated to bring the first fruit to the temple. Took to settle the land 14 years. 7 years of conquering the land and 7 years of settling the land. Then during these 14 years, the farmer was not obligated to bring his first fruit to the temple. Only after all the Jews were settled, only then you were obligated to bring the first fruit. Then the Rebbe once pointed out, why is it? Obviously in the 14 years, there were some Jews who got a piece of land very early, let's say after 1 year. They got a piece of land, they started to work the farm, they had food in the beginning. Why shouldn't they thank God for the first food? Why should they wait for 14 years? After 3 years, after 6 years, 14 years means all the Jews were settled, but 90% were settled before 14 years, and 80% were settled even earlier, and 60% and so on. Why we needed to wait until everybody was settled? The Rebbe says something very interesting. A Jew, we are all one nation. There is a saying in Hebrew, Kol Yisrael Arevim Zeh LaZeh. All the Jews are responsible, are guarantors for each other. But the word Arevim, the Baal Shem Tov said, tonight is the birthday of the Baal Shem Tov and of the Alter Rebbe, the first Chabad Rebbe. It's Chai Elul. The 18th of Elul. Chai means life. This year it comes out together with the 18th of September. We midnight. In Judaism, the day starts from sunset. It's Chai Elul already. Then the Baal Shem Tov said the word Arevim has three meanings in the same word. Arevim could means a guarantor, we are responsible for each other. Arevim could mean we are mixed with each other, Meuravim. We are all in one pot. We are all living together, we are all one unit. And the third meaning of the word Arevim is Arevim could be, we are tasty, we are enjoying each other. We are tasteful to each other. Ma'achal Arev means a very good food, a tasty food. Then we are tasteful to each other, we enjoy each other's company. And the idea is that the Jewish people are one unit. That when a Jew comes to he has to bring thank you to God, he has to thank to God for his first food, as long as he knows that there is one Jew is not settled, his joy is not complete. That he cannot come and say thank you, celebrate his good, celebrate his blessings, when he knows that there is still Jews who are on their own, still Jews are fighting, still Jews are trying to settle, and they do not have a farm, they do not have a good piece of land. And how could I celebrate and be happy and say thank you to God when I know that there is somebody also is not there yet. We see the same law, the same logic of the law, in another interesting law. You know, in Jewish law, during the winter, we in the Amidah, we pray for rain. During the summer, we pray for dew. What is winter and what is summer? From Sukkot until Pesach is winter. From Pesach until Sukkot is summer. When we start after Sukkot to pray for rain, when we start to ask for rain, to mention rain, we mention right by Shmini Atzeres. We start to say, Mashiva Ruach Morid HaGeshem. Asking for rain, praying to God to bring us rain, we wait 2 weeks. Until the 7th of Cheshvan. Why we wait 2 weeks? The Talmud says something very interesting. Because in the time of the temple, the Jews were obligated to make a pilgrimage to the temple. They had to go to visit the temple in Sukkot. The furthest Jew who comes from Sukkot, from Jerusalem, to his furthest place in Israel, would take him 14 days. Till the 7th of Cheshvan. Then the whole nation is waiting from asking for rain until the last schlepper makes it home. And you can ask yourself why in Israel rain is such a desperate need. People did not have what to drink in the olden days. Forget about the land and what to farm the land and this results in not having what to eat. Then you have an obligation if you're in need to turn to God. But the moment the Rebbe said like this, the moment a Jew knows there is somebody on the road who will suffer from my rain, I suddenly I don't need it anymore. I don't have the need for the rain. Because there is somebody on the road who is walking. And if it's going to rain, it's going to be full of mud and it will make it harder for him to make it to his home. Therefore, we all refrain from praying for rain because of one person. The whole community is stopping. Not only they are refraining for rain out of respect, the moment they know that there is somebody there on the road, suddenly they lose the need for rain. No, I don't need it. If my rain will cause somebody else suffering, I don't need it anymore. And the same thing is in the Bikurim. The idea is that when we can celebrate and say thank you to God, is only when we are know for sure that everybody can celebrate with us. And that's why the holidays are coming up. Jewish law says that you have to make sure that on the holidays, the poor, the widow, the orphan, the foreigner are also celebrating. Because if they cannot celebrate, it's not a celebration of God. Talmud says it's a celebration of your stomach. It's nothing with God. A celebration of God means that when you take care of others, of the less fortunate, and then God takes care of you in turn, then this is the biggest lesson from Bikurim. There is so many lessons there. One of the lessons is that only when you come to the land and only when everybody settles, only then you can enjoy your own blessings that you have.